Thank you, Chairman. It's a great pleasure of mine to collaborate with Dr. Profesoras from Spain on this global study. So as you have heard, you know, about this study was negative. The overall survival, there's a lack of benefit, but there's a hint of improvement in progression-free survival. So the question we have asked is that, is there any patient who may benefit? If there is, how do we identify them? So for this reason, we look for a biomarker selection, which is what we call a predictive biomarker. There are two biomarkers we look into. One is called EGFR, the other one is called KRAS. Now, EGFR stands for epidermal growth factor receptor. The mutation of EGFR is actually a very potent predictive biomarker for a tyrosine kinase inhibitor such as gefitinib or erdafitinib for non-small cell lung cancer. The question is, does it apply to the situation with sorafenib? Now, for this, you will see that on the one side is the EGFR mutation positive patient. You can see that there is the hazard ratio is 0.27, which is quite potent, suggesting about the difference in progression-free survival of 2.7 months versus 1.4 months. And then on the wild-type side, you see the hazard ratio is a bit less, but still positive of 0.62, with a significant p-value and 2.7 months versus 1.5 months. If you look lower down, there's something called the interaction analysis. Now, this is the important testing for a predictive power of the test. So when there is a significant p-value, there is a potential predictive power. However, I must warn you, the sample size is quite small because it's only a subgroup analysis, and also we did not have the opportunity to do multi-level testing. So everything I said can only be considered as an exploratory. Now, under the same tone, when you look at overall survival, you see that there is a benefit in mutation-positive patient. P-value 0.002, hazard ratio 0.48, 13.9 months versus 6.5 months. But on the wild type, there's no benefit. So again, there is a potential predictive power there. But again, I've emphasized the fact that this is exploratory. Now, moving on, KRAS. Now, KRAS is actually what we call a negative predictive marker. In a sense, patients with KRAS will actually survive shorter, and actually the outlook is worse. But then there's a one study from United States called the Battle suggesting that KRAS could be a predictive marker for sorafenib. And we're here to prove whether it is or it is not. But you can see the hazard ratio for this one is 2.46 with a significant p-value. And then on the KRAS wild type, you also see the exactly the same thing, hazard ratio 0.58 with a significant p-value. But when you look at the interaction value, that is only 0.69, suggesting that it is not a predictive biomarker. Similarly, KRAS on over survival, you also had hazard ratio 0.76 on the wild type, on the mutant, and then the hazard ratio 0.79 on the wild type, and again, the interactive p-value is negative 0.7. So I think in a sense is that we have established the fact that KRAS is unlikely to be a predictive biomarker. So in summary, based on this subgroup analysis, we make a hypothesis that EGFR mutation may be a predictive biomarker for sorafenib, but I have to use the word maybe with a quotation, lao. And then KRAS, on the other hand, we're able to accept the fact that it is not a predictive biomarker for sorafenib. But again, that all this data has to be interpreted with caution for the reason I mentioned. And thank you for your attention.